quadrupeds. I hope that you people might have practiced by creating certain views. Now let us move to the main part of rule number 6, which was the basis of rules. Now it says that a view should support same type of DDL DML just like a table. Now what does it mean? It means that whatever DML operations or DDL operations you were able to perform on table should also be allowed on a view. So we have seen that there are two types of views, simple and complex. Now what we have seen that if a view contains normal column, it is known as simple view. But if it contains a function or an expression or a formula, then it becomes a complex view, or you can say it has a complex column. So in this example, there are two simple columns and one complex column. So this new bal is an alias of balance plus 100, and this balance and name are the columns of the table. So let us move ahead and you can see that you can perform all operations on views, but the changes are reflected in the base table. Base table means the table on which the views has been created, but you cannot perform any DDL DML operation on a complex column. Let us see an example. Now today again I have created the same view, but this time the name is MyView6. As you can see, create view MyView6 as select name balance and balance plus 100 with an alias of new bal. So this view has three columns. Out of these three columns, two are table columns and the third one is the function or a expression with a name new bal. So whenever you type select star from MyView6, this query is executed. However, the data is coming from which table? Student table. Now if you look at student table, select star from student, it has four columns: roll number, name, city and balance, and it might have certain constraint also like primary key, foreign key. Let us see. Describe student. So it has roll number as primary key. Okay. Now please be very careful that your view has three columns, in which two are table columns. One is function or formula column. The main table has four columns, in which roll number is primary key. Now if you try to insert value in a view, it is allowed, given that no constraint is violated and also you don't insert any value in the function or formula or expression column. Let us see a very simple example. Create view MyView7 as select roll number, comma, city from student. Now you can see a view has been created which has taken only roll number and city. Now if you type select star from MyView7, you can see this. Now what will happen if I insert values in these two columns? See, insert into MyView7 values, say 33 comma merit, one row created. However, if you try to see now, select star from student, what you will find? You will find that this 33 merit has been inserted. Okay. Now you may ask question why it has come here. This I have explained you earlier also. This is totally in the control of Oracle. It should have come here, but because of storage management, Oracle has put it here. So leave it as it is. But you can see name has been left null and balance has been left null because there is no constraint on it and it is allowed. So if we try to perform a DML on a view, the values actually go in the main table. And if you try to type select star from my view 7, you can see the records. So that is not an issue. But if you try, if your view does not contain roll number and you try to insert the value, then it will give error. Or if you try to, for example, let us come back to our first view, that is my view 6. Let us see it again. Select star from student. These are the column. Select star from my view 6. These are the three column. Now let us try to insert values in it. Insert into my view 6 values. Now try to insert Kapil 999 comma 700. So what will we say? Column not allowed. Now virtual column not allowed is coming because of this 700. Now this 700 is going to entered in new bell, but you cannot enter a value in this new bell because there is a formula in it. So please remember, you cannot insert any value in a function based or a formula based call. As you can see, this was new bell. So when you try to insert the value, Oracle cannot decide you want to insert in balance or you want to in 100. So it is simply not allowed. Now if you try to skip this value, then what happens? You see values Kapil, something like this. It says not enough values. Now why it is saying not enough values? Because your view has three columns and you are trying to insert two, but it is not allowing you to enter the third value. So what to do? Now you know the trick. You can insert value only in these two columns by giving their names. So what you try to do is insert into my view 6, you give the name of the columns, name comma city, then you try to give the values name and balance, not city, balance. Insert into my view 6, name and balance, values. Now it is giving another type of error. Why? Because actually the view contains three columns, name, balance and new balance. But when these values are going in the main table has a column called as roll number, which is primary key. And you cannot leave primary key blank. So it is not allowing you here. So I hope you have understood the example. Please go through it again, create this table, create these views, pause the video, try to type, listen carefully and do these things. If you will practice, you will learn. So while entering values in views, you should be careful about the constraint, the number of columns, the type of column, whether it is a simple column or it is a complex column or whatever. Okay, so in next video, we will see the last and final chord rules. Thank you very much. Please practice it.